Welcome back to my channel. It is Taylor Nicole, and I always say I haven't spoken to you in a long time, but that's just how it's gonna be. I think one video a week is probably all I can manage right now. I wanted to give you guys an update on life before I leave town next week. I am about to go to Arizona to visit my sister, who you guys have met, Gabby, the one that I did the whisper challenge with and the yoga challenge with. She just moved to Arizona a couple months ago. I haven't seen her since then, haven't visited her, so I'm gonna go visit her. I leave on Sunday. You guys will see this video sometime this weekend. And then on the 10th, I fly down to go see Garrett. Lots of traveling, kind of bad timing because it's a really important time for Salted Road right now. There's a lot of progress being made. It's not the best timing for me to leave. However, I can't really change that now. These trips have been planned months ago. It's just the way life goes. I'm doing the best I can. So I wanted to give you guys an update on what I've been doing this past week and also just a little bit of things that people don't think about when they're starting a business. I knew it was gonna be a lot of work, a lot of paperwork, a lot of boring stuff mixed in with the fun stuff. But right now I'm like in the midst of the boring stuff, and so it's not like super exciting, but it's obviously very necessary. So you haven't been seeing a lot of like updates because it takes a while to work with the health department and stuff like that, and you won't start to see any updates or results for a few weeks, I guess is a good way to put it. First of all, I started to vlog earlier this week, and I have my planner here because I don't even remember what I did this week because it was just all over the place. And I started a vlog earlier, and I'm gonna show you guys a clip from that. Hi, my name is Taylor Christianson, and I am having a terrible day. On my channel, I like to keep it real, maybe a little too real, because when I have a bad day, I tell you I have a bad day. Man, life is frustrating sometimes, and I'm not gonna act like it's all giggles and sunshine. My computer froze, deleted everything off of my desktop, 2 hours of wasted time. All of my files were deleted, and then my computer just shut down. My computer broke a month and a half ago, and the hard drive failed. And I figured if I'm replacing a hard drive, I'm gonna replace it with a nicer one so it lasts longer. $500, which mind you, I don't have extra cash like that to spend. I need that to start the business. I need it to do YouTube videos. And today the hard drive fails again. It's been a month and a half since I fixed it for $500 and it broke. I just got out of my meeting with the health department and it was so helpful. I was having a really bad day. If you guys follow me on Instagram, you would see all my updates, but I just was like not having a good week last week, and then this week it's gotten a little bit better. It's turning around. Just everything was just going wrong and it was very frustrating. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram and you want to, my username is Taylor Christianson. No one's making you do anything, but if you want to follow that, then that's there, and I give you guys more updates throughout the week. Last time I talked to you guys, I was talking to you about how I pay for my tickets, and that's like house sitting and stuff. Holy cow, it has been like, wow, it's been a whole week. Okay. Last week, this is what I did. I work every Monday with my friend Bianca at her business, Lavender and Lemon Cleaning. I'm gonna put all of these links down below because these are just good companies and people I support and I want you guys to support, and they honestly just deserve way more business. I'm gonna put her stuff down below if you guys are looking for a house cleaner. She's the best. Cleaned with her every Monday, and then I went and met with my insurance agent to talk about some quotes for insurance. And then on Tuesday is my day off, which is not a day off. My day off is for Salted Road. So I worked a lot on Salted Road trying to get ready for a consultation that I had later that week. I had my pictures taken with my friend Greg, which I'll put the link down below for that. So I did some pictures with him just because all of my like profile pictures and stuff on social media, which now I consider a business because I make money on social media, all of my pictures were selfies, and I was like, if this is a business, I feel like I should look a little bit more professional, maybe have some pictures taken of myself, even though I feel super awkward. I can be weird. I can talk to a camera, but it's different when someone's like telling you to pose but look natural. I just can't mix the two of those, and it's really uncomfortable for me. So hated every process of that, but I got some pictures, and that was the point. The next day, Wednesday, I worked. So I worked the next like 4 days mostly at the coffee stand, which that's another thing too. Update, I told you guys where I worked, and if you guys really wanna know, then go follow me on Instagram. I talk about it on there, but it was one of those things that I was hiding it for a while because of my stalker at my last job. If you guys aren't aware, I had a stalker at my last job, tried to get police to do something about it, and they basically said, we can't do anything unless he's done something. And I was like, That seems backwards. Basically, I wasn't really protected and I had to find a new job. So I like left the city, found a new job somewhere else and didn't post anywhere on the internet because I just didn't, I don't know if he even uses social media, that guy was like older. I just wanted to protect myself from that. But then I was like, okay, well, when Salted Road opens, if you're new here, hello, my name is Taylor. I'm opening a coffee trailer. And I was like, when I'm open, people are gonna know where I'm at anyway. So like, what's the point in hiding where I'm at now? And people want to meet me, and there's a lot of people in the area that watch my videos, and I was like, well, what the heck? We have security and cameras, and I have self-defense stuff on me, so I feel safe. And if you're gonna try anything weird, like, I mean, you're gonna get caught, so just don't be weird. So I told you guys where I worked. That's just an update. It's been a busy week. Okay, so I worked last Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, not Saturday, and then I worked Sunday. I worked on getting health department stuff ready. I basically just had a consultation with the health department. So when you're gonna open like a mobile food unit or something like that, I mean, I don't know if it's different processes in different states. Like, I know things are different in different states, but at least in Washington state, you don't have to have a consultation, but there's a 30-minute free consultation if you wanna ask a bunch of questions about your plan review. So basically, when you're gonna build something, you wanna get your plans approved by the health department, because you don't have to. If you started to build and then you submitted your plans and they like didn't pass a bunch of the things you did, now you have to go back to your trailer or food truck or whatever you're doing and redo all those things, so you wasted your money. So basically, you wanna submit your plans. Once they're approved, then you start building, because then you know when you have your final review, like right before you open, before they approve you to open your business, then you know you're gonna pass and you're not gonna have to waste money on changing a bunch of things. We can't do a lot of stuff until we're approved by the health department, but it's a big process, costs a lot of money. I don't know what it is in other states, but in Washington state, you're offered a 30-minute free consultation if you wanna ask questions. Not necessary if you don't want to do it, but it's very helpful. I chose to do it just because to submit your plans, it's $600 and it takes them 4 weeks to review them. And then even after they're reviewed, you're not likely to pass the first time. Usually they're gonna request more information from you. And when you have to resubmit them, it costs more money. So easily it could end up being like a $1,000 process. It's in your best interest to do the consultation. So I was trying to get everything as prepared as I could. And on the website, they give you the checklist of all the paperwork that you're supposed to provide. Yada, yada, yada. Pretty boring. But I got that all prepared. Had a meeting with him on Friday. And he actually is so helpful. I've heard so many bad stories about health departments and inspectors and stuff. He's really helpful. He talked to me for an hour and answered a lot of my questions and was like still answering questions. And I was like, it's been like 45 minutes. It's been an hour. He's still talking to me. But he was super, super helpful. So now he gave me a list of things that I needed to fix about what I was bringing, which I'm like, that's so much more helpful. So now even my first plan review that I submit is gonna be even better than it would have been if I never met with him. I was trying to get everything submitted by this week because it takes a minimum of 4 weeks for them to review them, which is a long time to just be waiting and not building on the trailer. So I'm gonna be gone for the next 10 days. So I was trying to get everything submitted by this Friday, but there's a couple things that I just cannot get. People aren't very good about calling you back, and even if they do, it's probably gonna take them as long as next week, and then I'll already be out of town. And when I'm out of town, you have to like go actually submit your plans to the health department itself in person with the check. So obviously when I'm out of town, I can't do that. So I just didn't wanna waste 10 days, but that might have to be what the case is. I'm just doing my best. On Saturday, I was dog sitting for just 2 days. Saturday and Sunday, I had to go feed some dogs, and then I had my best friend's bridal shower, Bianca, who's the one I helped clean. And then I had to go to someone's house to go pick something up. Sunday, I had a meeting with one of my friends who's gonna help me with some marketing and stuff like that, which I still need to get a bunch of stuff together for her. But that was super helpful, and I'm super excited to work with one of my friends. I just like supporting my friends who are doing their own businesses, and we're all young and we're trying to get experience, and so it's really cool to work together. And then I worked. What's new? I cleaned with my friend, and then I had a phone call with our builder talking about all the stuff that we need to change from the health department that they gave us. And then I met with one of my friends because I like being busy and I like working on my goals, but like, you know, the point of life is relationships and friendships and stuff like that, and I never want my friends to feel like I don't make time for them. Whenever I can, I do that. So we met at like 7 at night and I hung out with my friend. So I fit it in. You don't have to like neglect all relationships when you're busy. People ask me that a lot and I'm like, I still hang out with people. It's not like I can't go on a full day excursion with someone because I just don't have the time. But like, if someone wants to spend time with me, I will make time for them and we will go get coffee or go get lunch or whatever. You still gotta make time for people in your life. Tuesday was my Salted Road Get Her Done Day is what I labeled it. And I basically just worked on this whole binder. This is our logo. if you've never seen it before. So I wanted to make it look as official as I could and clean, and I went and bought this nice binder, and I'm super excited about it. And I have all the labels here for all the things that I have to fill out. And I have a lot of the things kind of done from the consultation, but there's a lot of things I have to fix. So that's kind of what I'm working on in the mornings before I go to work. So I am working, today is Wednesday the 2nd of May. Holy cow, I can't believe it's May, that's insane. I work today, work tomorrow, work Friday, work Saturday, have a hair appointment Saturday, have a meeting with my dad tonight, hanging out with one of my friends tomorrow night, my friend's birthday on Saturday, hanging out with her. There's just a lot going on, but I keep telling Garrett, like, I'm trying to like earn my vacation, because if I'm gonna be taking 10 days off, like, I'll still be doing some work when I'm away, but that's a long time to not make any progress. So I'm like trying to work my little booty off now, just so that I feel like I don't feel guilty leaving if I get a lot of stuff done before I leave. That's why it's kind of crazy right now. I don't like to live my life this busy. Like, it's literally busy from morning to night. So if you want to know what goes into these binders, I'm going to try to make this quick. Just, I don't know, I could make a whole nother video about this if people are interested. I don't know how many people are trying to start a mobile business or food truck, coffee truck, whatever. But if you are, let me know. You guys can comment down below if you are. A little overview of the kind of stuff you have to provide for them. It's super exciting, so don't get too excited about it. I know you're gonna be pretty jealous. So the first thing is you need to provide the menu. And the reason they need to know your menu and the stuff that you're serving is to see, because you're either like low risk or high risk based on the kind of food you provide. If you're providing meat and stuff like that, obviously you're gonna need a commissary and you're gonna need a lot stricter rules than like me. I'm a low risk because it's just like espresso and I have machines plugged in, and there's no open food. It's all gonna be prepackaged and stuff like that, which I'm trying to keep it super simple. No like fresh food, at least now, because I would have to change things. If you keep it really simple, then you're low risk and it's a lot easier to, I mean, it's still a lot of work, but this is a lot easier than if you were to provide food that's open, meat, fruit, stuff like that. So you need to provide your menu and your food flow plan, which basically just explains how you're gonna prep everything that someone orders. So I don't even have the examples here, and it's probably different for every state, so you would just have to look on your health department website. But basically you just tell them like in detail, everything typed out. I'm gonna put on gloves, I'm gonna grab this, I'm gonna put it in this and grab a napkin. It, like, very specifically how you're gonna do every single process. Pretty fun. Okay, the next thing is LNI approval and also DMV. So you need to have proof of ownership and also like your registration for your vehicle to tow. If you're a food truck, I guess that's different, just proof of ownership. But since I have a trailer, I have to prove that I have a truck, so I have to bring my registration in. Plumbing, schematics, boring, but that's like for the builder. He has all that information that he's sending me. Scale drawing and details, again, they need to know measurements, they need to know exactly where everything's gonna be. Shelving, garbage cans, sinks, lighting, like everything, and measurements for every single thing in there. The next thing is zoning and permits, making sure you have the right permits and licenses and stuff to be serving in your city, in your county, in whatever area you're gonna be serving in. The next one is equipment. You have to name all of the equipment in there, which I don't know if every state is different on this, but Washington requires commercial grade fridges and stuff like that, just to make sure, you know, obviously your milk isn't gonna go bad. It's a good fridge. So you have to name all of your equipment, like the serial numbers, make and model, and pictures of everything, and very, very detailed. They like the detail. Service area and water source. So also commissary. A commissary is basically if you had to go prep some food before you open for business, and if you have like meat and stuff, you'd have to go cook it in a commercial kitchen that is approved by the health department, or cool it and then bring it. I don't really know because that's not my process, but if you were making food that you actually had to prep, you would make in a commercial kitchen, bring it into the trailer, and then reheat it. So basically nothing is supposed to be actually cooked in a mobile food unit. I don't need a commissary. They just passed an exemption bill in Washington state. I don't know what it's like in other states. It doesn't mean you don't need a commissary, but like someone that's low risk, like my trailer, I can request to not have one. So I did ask them to not have a commissary, which means I don't have to have an agreement with a commercial kitchen that I can use their stuff, because I don't need it, because I'm not prepping any food or anything like that. But I have to justify why I don't need it and how I'm gonna work around not having a commissary, which makes it tough because I have to find storage and I have to find a servicing area, basically. So I need to have someone that will give me water and have a water agreement, and it has to be potable water and, or potable, I don't know how you say that, I think it's potable. You have to have potable water, and it's super exciting. This is stuff people just don't think about, and this is what I've been working on like day in and day out, and it's hard because people don't answer your calls, or they a lot of people aren't really familiar with it. Where I live, there's not a lot of them. So I've called a few people and they're like, what are you doing? I don't understand what you need. Why do you need water? What are you doing? Like, they just don't get it. I'm trying to figure it out, but that's where I'm at. The next one is a restroom agreement, which you would need at events and stuff. You have to be within 200 feet of a restroom and you have to have the event sign off on it. But if you're at a public event, they obviously, if it's put on by the city, they're gonna have restrooms there and you will have a restroom agreement based on each event that you have. And then if you're at private locations, like a wedding or something like that, then they're just gonna assume that you have restrooms there already. And the next one is your site schedule. So if you're planning on going to a bunch of events through the city and stuff, basically just naming which ones you're gonna be at. And they always have a health official at every event to make sure everything's up to code. And the last one is operating procedures. So that is basically explaining like what a day in the life of Salted Road Coffee looks like. So like me getting up in the morning, where do I go? What time do I go grab this? Do I go shopping every single day for the milk and the products that I need, or do I have them stored somewhere else in a commercial fridge? All that kind of stuff. So it sounds like it's not a lot, but every single section has a lot of paperwork inside of there. So that's what I'm working on right now. This was kind of a long, boring video. Unless you're interested in doing something like this, now you know kind of what it looks like and the kind of stuff you have to work on. So in the meantime, I can't really put anything in the trailer. Our builders kind of has this on pause until we can get plans approved, which I don't even think I'm gonna be able to submit them before I leave, because there's some information I'm missing that I can't get yet because it's just not very accessible, but I'm working on it. So it might be next week, but the next video you guys are gonna see, I'm gonna be in Arizona with my sister. So thank you for watching. I hope if you're interested in this, that was helpful to you. Go look on your Department of Health website in whatever state that you're in, and they will have all this paperwork, or they should have all this paperwork for you. That's where I found all of mine, and my health department has been super helpful. And my advice is, like, instead of calling them, I would go in person and ask them the questions that they had. Garrett is calling me right now. I'll call you back in a second. Anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you guys have a good day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!